Hello students! Today we are going to discuss how to determine the epicenter distance using the Wedge method. This method uses a distance time graph where along the y-axis is time in minutes and on the x-axis is the epicenter distance in kilometers. Its line on the distance scale is 200 kilometers each. Thus we have 200 kilometers, 400 kilometers, 600 kilometers, 800 kilometers, 1,000 kilometers, and so on. Its line on the time scale is 20 seconds. Thus, we have 20 seconds, 40 seconds, 60 seconds, or 1 minute, and so on. To illustrate how the Wedge method is used, we answer some problems. Now, for number 1, the seismograph detects the arrival of the P wave at exactly 9:08 a.m., followed by the arrival time of S wave at 9:15 a.m. What is the lag time between the P and S wave and the distance of the epicenter to the seismic station? In this problem, we are given the P wave arrival time, which is 9:08 a.m. and S wave arrival time is 9:15 a.m. We are going to find for the lag time and the distance of the epicenter from the seismic station. To find for the lag time, we just get the difference between the S wave arrival time minus the P wave arrival time. So lag time is equal to 9:15 minus 9:08. 9 here is in hours and 15 and 8 are in minutes. We get the difference of hours and minutes. So 15 minus 8 is 7 minutes and 9 minus 9 is 0. Also, 0 minus 0 is 0. So our answer is 7 minutes. Once we get the lag time, we make use of the Wedge method on a distance time graph to determine the distance the epicenter is from the seismic station. Using scrap paper, we mark the 7 minutes lag time by positioning the scrap paper vertically along the y-axis on time in minutes. Then slide the paper such that the length corresponds to 7 minutes fits to the SP curve. Then project down along the epicenter distance scale to get the distance in kilometer. So here we have 5,400 kilometers as the distance of the epicenter to the seismic station. Then for number 2, a P wave arrived in Masbate at 1:10 p.m. The S wave arrived at 1:17 and 20 seconds. How far away is the epicenter? Here, the P wave and S wave arrival time are given, and we are going to find the distance in kilometer. Here, the time is in hours, minutes, and seconds. Lag time can be calculated using the same equation. Lag time is equal to S wave arrival time minus the P wave arrival time. For secondary wave, we have 1 p.m. 17 minutes and 20 seconds minus the arrival time of P wave 1 p.m. 10 minutes and 0 seconds. So for seconds, 0 minus 0 is 0, 2 minus 0 is 2, then for minutes, 7 minus 0 is 7, 1 minus 1 is 0, and for R, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. So we get 7 minutes and 20 seconds. Again, we find the length correspond to 7 minutes and 20 seconds. We get the distance equal to 5,800 kilometers. And for number 3, a seismic station is 9,000 kilometers from the earthquake's epicenter. Determine the lag time of P and S wave. Here, the given is the epicenter distance. What you are going to do is to mark the length between the PS curve that is equal to 9,000 kilometers. Then slide down to get the lag time. We get 10 minutes as the lag time. All right, we've done so far. I hope you learned a lot in this lesson. See you on my next video lesson. Goodbye and God bless. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.